not about how many times people are mentioned. It is why the Muslim people find those pictures offensive in a level that they can go and kill someone else. Here is the pictures of Jesus put together by same magazine. I'm not saying go and kill anyone. You don't like anyone to kill anyone. Are you Muslim? Okay, so when your prophet killed Asma bin Marwan, are you condemning your prophet and putting him in the rubbish? They cannot even say, I am ashamed what my prophet did. You should be ashamed what he did. You should be ashamed how he is causing damage to humanity. They shut down the freedom of speech, freedom of expression, freedom of belief, like everything. In Islam, there is no freedom.
Muhammad never had a thick skin to defend his prophethood. What happened is, can you move my camera as well from there?
Yes.
Muhammad was never able to defend anything. What happened is, individuals got killed. You need to make money. If you don't want to talk about it, here's the Quran. Here is Quran. Here is the Quran with the holes in it. Can you help me to get rid of it? If you don't want to talk about Muhammad, step one, we get rid of this book. It is very dangerous to humanity. It is calling non-Muslims worst of creatures. It is calling killing of apostates. No freedom of speech alongside of no freedom of belief. Yes, sir. I am talking about Islam and I am asking the question why your brothers thought it was all right to kill a teacher. That's hate speech. That's hate speech. So let's hear which is hate speech. Listen very carefully and help me to vote it. Sir, go away. Go away and defend your prophet. Maybe there are holes in my brain. Maybe there are holes in my brain. But still this verse goes under the hate speech. Listen very carefully. Indeed. The penalty for those wage war against Allah and His Messenger and strive upon earth corruption is none but they be killed or crucified or their hands and feet to be cut off from apostates or they will be exiled from the land. Is this love speech? Is this love speech? That is not love speech at all. That is hate speech. Comes from this book and comes from man who cannot even have any emotions. He cannot even handle any emotions. Quran and Muhammad is causing damage to humanity. That's all it is. And it is very much dangerous. 245 people were killed in France last couple of years with the magic word of Allah Akbar. Why? Because they were not Muslims or because they critic or mocked Muhammad. He is the only one you cannot touch. Even people just this week wrote article against the Queen of England. People are every day mocking the Prime Minister of England or the President of the United States everyone can get away with that. But the moment when you express the teachings of Muhammad, what happens? You say, actually, you don't even have time to say goodbye to your loved ones. Because your life is being taken away from you. Why? Because individuals follow the teachings of Muhammad with the example of Asma bin Marwa. Asma bin Marwan, a woman who writes a poem against Muhammad. Muhammad takes that as insult and mocking, and they killed her while she was breastfeeding a child. And it is the same in France. A teacher simply shoves the caricatures of Muhammad. What happens to him? A follower of Islam comes with using the magic word of Allah Akbar, chops his head off, and that's not enough. He puts that on the social media to set the example. Why? Let me tell you why.
The Muslims condemn the actions had to online, on the media, on social media.
They did not condemn the action. They blamed the guy for showing the pictures. Why? Because Muslims are so sensitive. Actually, let me show you some of the condemnation comes. Listen very carefully. It's not funny.
No, it's not funny.
It's not funny at all.
We should condemn this. This guy is condemning this.
It's not the action. You need to get rid of Muhammad because individuals are following the teachings of man called Muhammad.
If you study history, we have no proof, no evidence, no scripture, no money, no architecture, nothing to prove that Muhammad, what is called the founder of Islam, he's not the one. I have. You know, she was ex-Muslim, and she know that Muawiyah.
It has nothing to do with if I'm ex-Muslim or not, sir. There is something you can respect. That's absolutely fine. But the question is, does the leader of the ideology of Islam, does he respect me? No. He calls me the worst of creatures. He calls me to be killed. Even some of your Muslim brothers at Speaker's Corner are calling me to be killed. Why? And by the way, don't think kafir is a compliment. Word kafir is not a compliment at all. It is not a compliment.
By the way, Muhammad is a nickname. It means the Jesus. Muhammad
has nothing to do with Jesus, sir.
Muhammad in Arabic is Mumashad. Muhammad is somebody very special, you know? Al-Muhammad, Al-Mumashad. You cannot call somebody. Jesus is all fake. All religion are fabricated. Let's be honest. Okay, this woman, she's converted from Islam to Christianity. Good luck to her. But me, I was ex-Muslim. I am not gonna be Christian because I study Christianity, and Christianity is fake religion. Exactly, because I study Christianity all my life. I have no, you have no evidence, no proof of what happened exactly with the whole of the New Testament.
Sir, we do know who wrote the New Testament. We do know Christian scripture is true and reliable, and not only that. We know Lord Jesus Christ is the only solution to this broken world. But right now, my focus what? You know what is my focus right now? My focus is why when someone tries to practice their freedom of speech, someone decides to take the head of someone else.
Agree.
That's what I am asking.
Okay,
I don't want you to agree with me.
I
want you to help me to get rid of Muhammad. Because people are following the teachings of Muhammad. It is the teachings of Muhammad is causing problems and problems and problems.
Can I ask a question? question as an atheist. Yeah. You are an atheist, I understand.
I am not an atheist. No. Humanity, you know one thing she said. You know what is the solution for our planet? Humanity, my friend.
Jesus Christ!
How do you know it's good, though?
No, that is extremely good. That's where we need to really concentrate about our humanity. We're all human beings. No matter what we believe, no matter how we look like.
It does matter, sir. It does matter what we believe. If you are following a religion which is telling you people who do not believe in Muhammad and who do not believe in Allah, they are the worst of creatures. Then it becomes, it is matter what you believe. Because what you believe, you live your life for what you believe. It is matter what you believe. If your ideology is saying, chop the heads, hands and feet of those people, it does matter. And of course it does matter. He is the social media. How the followers of Islam is blaming the teacher for shoving the cartoons of Muhammad. Why? Because people know Muhammad is untouchable. Why they do it? Sir, do you think people should draw such a picture? And by the way, those of you who know a little bit of Islam, you would know that Muhammad is being drawn very, very pretty in these pictures. He is very pretty. He is very, very pretty in those pictures. But the followers of Islam simply could not handle that.
Okay, Christianity. I regardless why you. Fake,
but it's better on the
picture. But you know why? You know why better? God. But it's fabric man-made. How good man? You love your enemy.
Even though it can be
a Christian, my friend.
What? If no one is being getting killed, sir, can you help me? Can you help me to think through those? Can you help me to figure this out, please? If no one gets killed, Muslims are saying no one is being getting killed. Yes, sir. I want him to condemn the teachings of Muhammad. That's all I am asking.
What happened in Paris, Mr. Brown? I think he's going to condemn them.
No, I don't think so.
Yeah, what happened? They're behaving in Paris.
What happened in Paris?
Let me fill you in what happened in Paris.
Happened in Paris.
2020. A French teacher is being killed simply shoving the cartoon of Muhammad. And he is killed by the follower of Islam. Don't get confused that he was killed by an atheist. Please do not get confused that he was killed by an Asian. Please do not get confused. He was killed by a foreigner. Please make sure you are clear that he was killed by the follower of Islam. 2018, four people were killed in France by someone who used the word Allah Akbar. 2016, people are being killed. 2015, people are being killed. You lost them? We want to lose Muhammad. Altogether, 245 people are being killed by and because of the teachings of Muhammad. That's just unacceptable in any form or in any shape.
People actually worship this
paper. I'm disgusting shit. I am not Muhammad. I don't understand why you see me, why you see Muhammad when you look at me. I am not Muhammad. This is the mind shuts down the freedom of speech. This is the mind shut down freedom of speech. Sir, are you condemning your prophet for ordering the people who mocked him? Are you condemning your prophet for focus? Are you condemning your prophet for ordering mockery of the people? Sir, are you condemning your prophet for order killing of the individuals who mocked him? Just simple yes and no answer. So you are not condemning it, you are smiling to it. Yes, you are smiling. You are smiling because people from your ideology killed a teacher who showed the pictures of Muhammad, and you are smiling. I think that is just double wonderful. Don't you think that is wonderful? Yeah. You know why I do? Because your ideology is so dangerous. People need to do it. Your ideology is so dangerous, and Muslims need to give up that ideology. It is so dangerous, causing damage to humanity, and you are smiling to that. Sir, which part of Islam is good when people are being killed because they show the pictures of Muhammad? Answer my question. Which part of Islam is good when people are being killed because they show the pictures of Muhammad? That's very easy. You think it's funny? 2020 at Speaker's Corner, you are simply laughing because the follower of Islam killed individuals. And you think it is funny? If it is nonsense, why your brothers are killing individuals? Sir, how old are you?
I am
23. Do you think should we have right to show the pictures of individuals? Do you think should we have the right to show the pictures of individuals? Yes. Okay. This is picture of Jesus. This is picture of Jesus, and people did make mockery, and Muslims every week at Speaker's Corner makes mockery of Lord Jesus Christ. Every Sunday, Muslim makes mockery of Lord Jesus Christ. None of the Muslims ever been even told to shut up. Freedom of speech, sir. So this is still making people to live heavily after. But picture such this picture. This is not the Charlie Hebdo one. This is Charlie Hebdo one. Picture like this one. Look at them. Picture like Muhammad's one is causing people to be get killed. See the differences? This picture makes you to live happily after, even though it is very offensive. This picture is making you to get killed within short time. Why? Because man in this picture doesn't allow you to live happily after if you are not Muslim. I'm not lying, sir. Just turn on the news. If you are simply denying that. Some of them I did. So there is nothing wrong with that. I am first. I practiced the gift God given to me to draw a picture of Muhammad, as well as I draw the picture of rabbit, as well as draw the picture of dog. What is wrong with this picture? What is wrong with this picture?
It probably didn't look that way. It's probably not that way.
Oh, so you don't think Mohammed was this handsome? You don't think Mohammed was handsome? I think this is very nice representative of Mohammed. Look at the heads. Look at the heads Mohammed get rid of.
My grandfather.
A Muslim is making mockery of his prophet, and he can get away with that. But as a Christian, when I show the picture of Mohammed, or a French history teacher shows the picture of Mohammed, what happens is, goodbye to your life. Have you noticed something interesting happened on the news? While people who shove the picture of Mohammed get killed, still BBC and Sky, out of respect, every time when they use the word Mohammed, they are adding the word prophet in front of it. BBC is saying, because this teacher showed the picture of Prophet Muhammad. Muhammad is not a prophet. Muhammad is not a prophet, especially for non-Muslims. And Muhammad is very dangerous for humanity. Very dangerous. Not only his teachings are causing danger to humanity.
The only prophet
I am dangerous. Why did you say that, ma'am? This is the picture of Muhammad. You think Muhammad is rubbish? You think Muhammad is rubbish? Why does it matter who made it?
You made those pictures at home.
What kind of picture is this? So according to Islamic teaching, when Muhammad put his tongue in your mouth, you are going to get eternal life.
According to your brain.
I am mad.
Why not? It's a picture. You can call it.
How dare I am? How dare this man causing danger to humanity? How dare this book is causing danger to humanity? It's my book. I can do whatever I want. You know, I can simply do this as well. I can do whatever I want. I bought it. I paid it. I can do whatever I want. Why cannot you defend your prophet? I'm talking rubbish. That's Muhammad. People think Muhammad is speaking rubbish. I agree with that. Why is that insulting? How can... Okay, let me read you something. Now. Do you think is this insulting?
I don't care what you say.
I'm gonna read the word of Allah. You can run away. You wanna run away from the word of Allah? It's absolutely you. Let me read this and then see what kind of compliment you are receiving from your prophet. Okay? While Allah and angels, they're all terrorists. That's not funny. It is not funny. Let me read. Listen how Allah using angels to cause terror in your heart. Listen very carefully. This is the Allah 1.8 billion people are following with this man called Muhammad.
I don't think he's 1.8. That's all propaganda.
Even if it is one person, that is still dangerous. It's not about the numbers. But even if it is only one person, that is still very much dangerous. So let me read the verse and you help me to understand if this verse does not identify Allah as the terrorist. Listen very carefully. And angels.
You need a man.
When your Lord inspired to the angels, I am with you. So strengthen those who have believed. I will cast terror into hearts of those who disbelieve. So strike them upon the necks and strike them from every fingertips.
This man's free. Take her out, man. Take her out for dinner.
You're allowed four. Why does she have four wives?
She's frustrated. She's frustrated.
Take her out for dinner.
Yes, I am. I am very much upset. I am very much upset. What the followers of Muslims are when the followers of Islam is taking the life of individuals.
You're obsessed with sex. With children, it's
so what happened in France? Are you condemning what happened in France? Are you condemning what happened in France? So I am obsessed with sex. I am obsessed with sex. That's what Muslim says. Muhammad was sleeping around day after day, even during the daytime, night and day. He was.
And you can be filmed.
He should be going to prison for what he's done, but he got away with that. While he was having lots of sex with boys and girls and with women, what happened? He was still out of control. So, sex is not the solution. Sex is not the solution. Sir, are you condemning what happened in France? Are you condemning what happened in France?
That's your sex obsessed.
Talking about sex.
Are you condemning what happened in France?
Maybe you're the pedophile.
So, he doesn't want to condemn what happened in France, and he looks at me, and then he sees his prophet who had sex with a child. Do I look like same?
No,
look,
no.
Maybe.
Maybe. You're the pedophile.
Same smile.
You're the pedophile.
Look, same smile. Maybe I need to make my hair look a little bit nice. Let me make my hair look a little bit nice. Look, same. Now we are the same. Now it makes sense. Muslim look at me, they call me liar because they see their own prophet. Muslim look at me, they call me hate creature because they see their prophet. Muslims look at me, that's their prophet. That's Muhammad. Does he not look at me? Why do you think it's funny? Would you prefer this one? Muhammad orders 72 virgins to his followers that is very Islamic.
I'm just telling you the truth.
What is the truth?
You know Muhammad, he was Christian.
You can mock. You can mock as much as you want. And you know, you can get away with that because I am Christian. But the moment if I think to mock, what happens is someone might come and separate my neck from my body. As it has been done to in France on Friday. A teacher has been killed because he simply showed the picture of Muhammad in the classroom to discuss the freedom of expression. A follower of Muhammad uses the magic word called Allah Akbar and people are being killed. That magic word has a history. Muhammad says Allah Akbar and then he got rid of the Kabar. That magic word causes up to 900 people to be get killed. The magic word Allah Akbar caused a Muslim who identify himself as a Muslim, follower of ideology of Islam, to take the life of a teacher. Do you condemn what happened in France?
She's quoting your book. Is your book rubbish?
Sorry? What happened? In France, a teacher, history teacher, in the group in the discussion, and you know the story, are you condemning it?
So why don't you tell her what she's going on?
You are not condemning it. Why not condemning it? So you are quite okay for...
You don't know.
So, are you quite okay for teacher to be killed? No.
Anybody kill anybody.
You don't like anyone to kill anyone? Are you Muslim? Okay, so when your prophet killed Asma bin Marwan, are you condemning your prophet and putting him in the rubbish?
I said no, this is right in your book. You want to refute? Quote your book.
No, that's there. He know what's he doing, why he doing like that.
Also, it depends what they do. It depends what you do. Therefore, it will be condemned or it will be not condemned.
That guy is not the Islam. That's guy. That's meaning. I know somebody is not good for anywhere. Here, or here, or here, or anywhere. Somebody like this is not good. Because that is Yahudi and it's not guy. It's not good. Yahudi is not. No, it's like this. There is some guys is good. They like them. People, they like the people. Not the same. They say, this is what I'm doing. Everywhere here. Not all the same.
So what I am hearing from you is that was just some guy who had nothing to do with Islam. Sir, are you Muslim? No. If you are not Muslim, in your conversations or before you have your lunch, would you say the word Allah Akbar? Allah Akbar in Arabic means Allah is greater. Would you say that? No. You are a random person, but you wouldn't say Allah Akbar? No. Sir, you wouldn't say Allah Akbar? You are a random person. Who says Allah Akbar? It is the Muslim frame. It is the Muslim magic word. It is the magic word of Muhammad. It is the magic word of Muhammad. When Muhammad screamed Allah Akbar, and then he went to Kabar and killed up to 900 men. That is the magic word is used by Muslims alone. Not by Christians, not by atheists, agnostic or other faiths, not even by Sikhs, okay? It is the word, let me finish. It is the word used by Muslims and it is the word belong to Islam. And person killed in the intention of setting the example for those people who practice their freedom of speech by showing the pictures of Muhammad.
I want to tell you something. If I teach you how using the car, if you're making accents, this from your teacher will touch you or from you?
That's a good comment. So if you teach me how to use the car, once I get involved into car accident, is it my teacher's fault or is it my fault? That's a good question. Okay, that's a good question. So I'm gonna take you back to Muhammad. And then we get to hear from Muhammad in his teachings. So he sets the example. According to Muslims, okay, Muhammad is your perfect example. The way he went to bathroom, the way he had sex, the way he killed people, that is the example set for you. Okay? So, listen your example. Listen your example. The penalty for those who wage war against Allah and the Messenger and strive upon earth corruption. Please go. Muslims don't even want the other Muslims to hear and defend their prophet. Once you do not talk about the problems you have in your faith, it is going to cause more and more deaths. Why? Because you are not identifying the issue. And there is a problem. From bottom line to top line, there is a problem in Islam. It is very dangerous problem. You look at the examples of Muhammad, and examples of Muhammad is causing, and teachings of Muhammad is causing people who critique Islam to be killed. That is not acceptable at all. It is not even acceptable in 21st century.
That's it. So all your religion is fabricated, your religion.
And her religion. And it's 100%.
Do you like this picture of Muhammad, sir? Do you like the picture of Muhammad? You have no view?
No.
Sir, do you like the picture of Muhammad?
So when you say Jesus,
do you like the picture of Muhammad? Should I have right to draw this picture? Oh, his teeth were broken. His two holy teeth is broken in the Battle of Badr. Another picture of Muhammad. It is the Jewish people who steps in and then helps Muslims when they are in need. Pictures seem to say stop laughing because a Jew is helping a Muslim. And Muhammad.
What about your religion? You're okay, I agree with you. 100 million.
I don't want you to agree with me. I want you to come alongside of me and then get rid of this book. I want you to come alongside of me and then help me to get rid of Islam. That's all I want. Because problem is not Muslims. The problem is Islam. The problem is the ideology. There are lovely Muslims, and he can show those pictures. It's absolutely fine. We are not going to kill him, but when the individuals show the picture of Muhammad, they do get killed. That is the problem. That is the problem.
Finally,
it is already too late. All I am asking them to condemn Muhammad.
Are you condemning Muhammad?
He's not condemning what his fellow brothers did. See that? Shish. You're still telling me shish? You are still 21st century ed speakers corner telling me to shish.
When I read the Bible,
that is just unacceptable. It is seriously unacceptable because if you do not talk about the problems, we will never able to address the issue to solve it. There is a problem. There is a problem. And problem is book called Quran, man called Muhammad, ideology called Islam, alongside of Allah and angels. And 21st century Muslims are saying shush, and they think that's funny. So are you Muslim? You are not Muslim. Good for you. Very good for you. Well done for getting rid of Islam.
He followed Christian prince, that's why he left Islam, he said.
He followed Christian prince, he left Islam. So you follow Christ now. Thank you, brother Christian prince, for all the work he's doing to get rid of Islam. But still more work to do.
Ask your Muhammad. He knows.
I simply want to ask the question: why Muslims find these pictures so offensive in a level they can go and kill someone else? Why? Why?
And sir, 220 times Moses in the Quran. Why? You don't answer this question. Why 200 times? Number one personality in the Quran is Moses.
Yes.
Moses is number one.
It's not about how many times people are mentioned.
And next to Jesus, 25 times.
It is not about how many times people are mentioned. It is why the Muslim people find those pictures offensive in a level that they can go and kill someone else. Because Muhammad is rubbish. I am full of rubbish because I am holding a picture of Muhammad. I am full of rubbish because I am holding the picture of Muhammad. Can you imagine what would they call someone if that person is following Muhammad? Just holding the picture of Muhammad makes me rubbish.
What about the followers of Muhammad? What about especially the followers of Muhammad who takes the life of others? What do you call them? Lovers of Muhammad. You will call them lovers of Muhammad, but you will call me rubbish. Because I was very gentle and then I brought nice pictures of Muhammad. You are the last person who tells me go home. Especially at Speaker's Corner, sir. If you cannot handle, leave it. Go and come with your mom. Go and come with your mom. What is wrong with this picture? Ma'am, are you Muslim? You don't even want to get involved. Are you okay? Your Muslim brothers are killing non-Muslims. Are you okay for your Muslim brothers to kill non-Muslims? I am not asking you to tell me your biography. I am not asking you to tell me about how to make falafel. I am asking, are you condemning what Muslims are doing? And you are saying me, don't talk to me. That is simply coming alongside of the crime. I have the pictures of Muhammad, and those of you who are watching, and those of you who are gonna watch, please send me the pictures of Muhammad. We have a Muhammad week.
I found it a little bit too much.
We have a Muhammad week so that people will learn to defend their prophet. Those pictures are causing Islam to be shaken, because those pictures are addressing that Islam still has nothing to do to defend. Islam stands on nothing. They can't even handle a picture. They shut down the freedom of speech, freedom of expression, freedom of belief, like everything. In Islam, there is no freedom. In Islam, there is no freedom. Why? Because Muhammad, no one knows how to defend Muhammad. Therefore, they simply come and kill you. No one knows how to defend Muhammad. Therefore, when a teacher in France shows the pictures of caricatures of Muhammad in the intention of expression of the freedom of speech, he gets killed. How unstable this ideology is, and how dangerous this ideology is. Here is the pictures of Jesus put together by same magazine. I'm not saying go and kill anyone. People is expressing their freedom of speech by critiquing core foundation of my faith. It is the same thing week after week. Muslims at Speaker's Corner are mocking and lying about my God. It is exactly the same thing. But none of the Christians are hurting others, but it is only the moment pictures of Muhammad is out there, people are being killed. Unacceptable. 245 people in France with those magic words of Allah Akbar are being killed. Last couple of years, 245 lives are being taken away. Unacceptable. And you hear Muslims don't even want to talk about it. They don't even want to defend their prophet, or they don't even want to condemn the action. If you come alongside of the action, you are simply saying, let's go and kill other individuals who hold the pictures of Muhammad. Even though the picture they hold is very nice. Unacceptable at all. Sir, are you Muslim? Are you Muslim, sir? You are a human being. Is your belief Islam or not Islam?
I've just come to listen, I don't get involved.
Okay, let me ask you a question.
What is this, what are you speaking about?
Are you condemning what happened in France?
I don't know what's going on. I'm not watching TV.
You don't even know what's going on in France. I'll fill you in. I fill in.
So please speak.
Yeah, I'll fill in. On Friday. On Friday. Sir, you said you come here for the news. I'm going to fill you in with the news. On Friday, a French teacher, history teacher, is being killed, not killed actually, slaughtered by a follower of religion of Islam. Because in the classroom, he shoved the pictures of Charlie Hebdo on Muhammad to have a discussion on the expression of freedom of speech. Do you condemn a Muslim who killed this French teacher? What is it you don't know? Are you condemning someone who killed another person?
Killing is wrong.
Killing is wrong. Okay, so do you condemn all killings? Okay, would you condemn someone if, let's say, they wrote, sir, are you listening? You said you come here for the news. I'm giving you the news. Yeah, so. Sir, there are some basic questions. I'm not going to ask you to give me the formula for quantum physics.
Speaker's corner, you don't speak to just one person. You speak to lots of people. Speaker's corner.
Do you see how Muslims don't even want to talk about it? How Muslims don't even want to talk about it? Doesn't matter where you are from. The moment you are not condemning the teaching killings of French teachers, you are coming alongside of it. People are being killed simply they shove the pictures of Muhammad so that they can have a discussion on freedom of speech, and you have zero opinion about it. That's already sad.
I've heard about it's COVID, blues in your shoes, blues. That's all I'm hearing in the news. COVID, blues. I don't know anything else.
I already filled you in with the news, sir. You have zero excuse now.
I don't even wear the mask. I don't know what's going on.
Sir, you have. You just lied to me in front of all those people.
This is news to me.
Let me express why you lied. You say all you are hearing about on the news is COVID. And now you are telling me I am not even putting mask because I don't know what's going on. You lied. You are as worse as your prophet.
This is the first time I've heard it.
So first time you heard of it, in your first time, are you going to condemn it? That's all I'm asking you.
Killing is wrong.
Okay.
Whether you're in France, whether you're in Hyde Park, wrong is wrong. Whether a politician does it, whether
Indian is killing okay? Listen now, listen. Is the killing is okay? Listen. Listen.
It's all wrong against humanity. I didn't want to speak. It's all wrong against humanity. So don't come here trying to provoke people. This is the first time I've seen this. I've seen it on TV. I'm not even watching TV. I came here to get away from something, to learn something, and you're condemning me of something I don't even know. Of course it's bloody wrong. Of course it's wrong. Who says it's wrong to kill people? He says it's wrong.
Yeah.
What French program do you watch?
So you are upset that someone's head is wrong?
Mother is wrong, whoever it is. That's it. Carry on. Don't single me out because I'm waving this and I look like a half Turk. 16th century. Thank you very much.
Yeah. When Mohammed killed Asma bin Marwan, because she wrote a poem against Muhammad. Was that wrong? How old are you, man? How old are you? Under 20, over 20? Over. Do you think should people be killed because they hold the pictures of Muhammad? No. Should people be killed because they draw the pictures of Muhammad? No. Should people be killed if they write poem against Muhammad? No. What are you going to say to the followers of Islam who takes the life of people because they show the pictures of Muhammad, they draw the pictures of Muhammad, or they write poem against Muhammad. You don't even want to come in contact with them. So it makes you scared. It makes you scared. If I don't know Islam, educate me. Educate me if I don't know Islam. When the word Allah Akbar, it doesn't teach? Does Islam not teach? Are you Muslim? Say the Shahada for me. Say the Shahada for me. If you are Muslim, can you say the Shahada for me? Sir, if you are Muslim, can you say the Shahada for me? You don't know the Shahada, you are Muslim. You know the Shahada, but you know that Islam doesn't teach the order of killing anyone. It doesn't, okay. This is the translation of the Quran. If you want, here's the Arabic. You can check it out. Surah 12. I'll hold it actually. Do you read Arabic, sir? No, then you go with English. I read it for you. Listen very carefully and then tell me how this religion is teaching peace. Okay? Remember,
killing is a sin.
So killing is a sin.
You agree?
Can you come close with? So killing is a sin. Okay.
Yes.
Therefore, if someone kills, they sin. Okay. So I'm gonna read 4 verses for you, and then I'm gonna bring up couple of stories for you, and I want you to after those stories, I want you to tell me you condemn Muhammad. Okay. First verse. When your Lord inspired the angels, I am with you. So strengthen those who have disbelief, who have believed. I will cast terror in the hearts of those who disbelieve. Surah 8 verse 12. I will cast terror in the hearts of those who disbelieve. So strike them upon the necks and strike them from every fingertips. Islam doesn't teach killing. It simply says Allah and angels are casting terror in your hearts and saying strike the heads of disbelievers and strike the every fingertips of the disbelievers. Okay? That's the first one. Second one. Are you listening to the second one? 5:33. Indeed, the penalty for those who wage war against Allah and His Messenger and strive upon earth corruption is none, but they will be killed or crucified, or that their hands and feet to be cut off from opposite side, or they will be exiled from the land. That is for them is a disgrace in this world, and for them in the hereafter is great punishment. They will be killed or crucified, or their hands or feet to be cut off. Is that peace? Is that the peace? Just a moment. Is this the sin?
Go back to the first surah.
You tell me what is.
I read. The context of the first surah.
You tell me.
Tell me the context.
You tell me.
The surah is when the non-Muslims and the Muslims, there's a war. When there's a war, what are you going to do? They're going to throw roses when there's a war. They're going to kill the opposition.
You told me killing is the sin. I read you two verses. Excuse me. I read you two verses, and now you are justifying killing of non-Muslims.
If there's a war,
do you hear that? Do you hear that? Excuse me. That doesn't look like defense at all. Go and strike. Allah and angels are casting terror in the hearts of disbelievers.
Is that a war?
You are in a war with me because I do not believe in Allah and Muhammad.
If there's a war, I come and attack you. I try to kill you. What are you gonna do?
The verse doesn't say it's in a war. Allah simply identifies disbelievers to be killed. Not only be killed, but from every fingertips to chopped off. Is that loving verse, sir? Is that a loving language? Chopping off to someone's fingertips, is that a loving language? That's in the Quran. Are you Muslim?
Which part?
You are Muslim. I am asking the question, are you condemning what happened in France on Friday? And Muslims are telling me, oh, Islam is so beautiful, so loving, so peaceful, but I cannot find those peaceful verses here. Are you condemning what happened in France?
Yeah, I am condemning. Yeah.
You are condemning? Yeah. Okay. Are you condemning when Muhammad killed a woman because she wrote poem against her?
No, I don't think so.
You are not condemning your prophet?
No. Prophet Muhammad never killed the innocent. Muhammad never killed the innocent.
I already told you, crime of this woman was writing poem against Muhammad. So was she innocent?
No, I don't think so. This is.
So she wasn't innocent.
No, you cannot prove that.
Writing poem against Muhammad is your crime. Holding the pictures of Muhammad is a crime.
No, I don't think so. You cannot prove that.
I cannot prove that?
Yeah, you cannot. When he came, they were killing during the baby girl, and he stopped that. How come he's killing?
Give me your evidence.
Yeah.
Give me your evidence.
My evidence? Look at.
Give me your evidence. You told me Muhammad came and stopped killing of the children. Give me your evidence.
The Quran you mentioned.
Give me your evidence.
Look at the Bible.
Give me your evidence. Because I am going to give you. What's your name, sir?
John.
I'm going to give my evidence to you. Have your prophet order killing a woman who wrote poem against Muhammad. Okay?
Yeah.
So, I read the verse for you.
Okay.
I read the story for you.
Okay.
And then after that, I want you to tell me you are condemning your prophet and your prophet needs to go to hell as soon as possible. He's already in hell, but I'll give you a chance to verbalize that since you are not happy with that. Okay? Are you ready? Are you ready?
Always. Surah Tekfir, verse 8.
Wait, sir.
Surah Tekfir, verse 8.
What is the name of the chapter?
Tekfir.
Number of the chapter?
8.
Chapter 8? Still you are saying Shushet Speaker's Corner, you need to go and defend your prophet, you need to come to Speaker's Corner with your mother if you are still saying Shushet Speaker's Corner. Don't come to Speaker's Corner if you are saying shush. Thank you. I'm waiting you to read the verse for me, sir.
Why did you say just a second?
Where is the verse coming? From Mecca by camel? Come on, sir, where the verse is coming? Is the verse coming from Saudi Arabia and stopped by ISIS as they were feeding ISIS?
Come from there. It's come from Google.
Oh, you went to Google to find out the verses to defend your prophet, and Sheikh Google is not helping you. That's already a sign of sadness. Come on, sir, give me the reference. Give me the, read the verse for me. What is the number of the verse? What is the number of the verse?
Number of the At-Takbir, Surah At-Takbir.
What is the number of the chapter?
8.
Chapter 8 verse?
Yeah.
Chapter 8 verse what?
Chapter 8 verse 8.
Chapter 8 verse 8.
Takbir.
What is the number of the chapter?
What is chapter means? What is that in English? Surah.
Yeah, 66. Number of Surah 66 verse
8.
Surah 66 verse 8. Apparently, Muhammad is stopping the killing of the children. Every time when you hear Bismillah Rahman Rahim or Allah Akbar, you know what to do. You need to run as fast as you can, because when those words are coming out, that means death is next to you. That's how it is.
This is original.
Surah 60 verse.
Bismillah, I'm saying.
Shush, man. It's freedom of speech, man. What's wrong with you? Don't clean the teeth.
Oh believers, turn to Allah in sincere repentance, so your Lord may absolve you of your sin and admit you into garden, under which you are slow, unto the day Allah will not disgrace the prophet or the believers. With him, their light will shine ahead of them, and on their right, they will say, O Lord, perfect our light for us and forgive us, for you are truly most capable of everything.
Mr. Muslim John,
Sorry,
I ask you the question, is your religion is peaceful? Are you condemning what happened in France? You said, yes, Muhammad is peaceful. He comes and then stops the killing of children.
Yeah.
And then I've been waiting for the reference. And then reference you give it to me is simply saying, if you follow Muhammad, Allah is going to give you paradise. And then if you read more verses, it is going to tell you about the books of these virgins you are going to get in paradise. So, with your mind, I am sure you know, wait. I am sure you know that verse has nothing to do with what happened in France and what Muhammad teach. So now, bring your mind back to speaker's corner and defend your prophet. Let me read one of the amazing thing your prophet did. Okay? And then after I read this, I want you to tell me your prophet should burn in hell forever. Okay? Listen very carefully. Are you listening, sir? Sir, are you listening? Is that your listening face?
Yeah,
is your listening face? Okay, put your listening face. Ibn Ishaq, page 675-676. Story of Asma bin Marwan. Asma bin Marwan wrote a poem against Muhammad. When the apostle heard that she has, when apostle heard what she said, he said, "Who will get rid of Marwan's daughter?" Ubay bin Arad al-Khatma, who was with him, heard him, and that very night he went to her house and killed her. In the morning he came to Muhammad and told him what he had done. And Muhammad said, "You have helped Allah and his prophet." And this woman was breastfeeding her child. So your prophet cannot handle a poem which is written against him, and then he orders this woman to be killed. And once woman is being killed, your prophet says, "You helped Allah and you helped me." Can you tell me your prophet should burn in hell for not allowing freedom of speech?
I need to learn what happened.
I told you what happened. Yeah. There is nothing you need to go and learn. So what happened is, according to Islamic sources, are you condemning for Muhammad for what he has done?
I am going to say some, in some situation, according to Islam, people can be killed.
According to teachings of Islam, people can be killed. Yes. Should people be killed?
I need to understand what you are saying, Mr. Muhammad.
Muslim, yeah. I need to understand what you are saying.
Don't speak to
me. Do you think?
Don't waste your time.
Why not?
You're wasting your, it's like you're better off talking to a brick wall.
Sorry?
Go and talk to brick wall.
Alhamdulillah. No, you're wasting your time talking to her.
Why?
She doesn't listen. She's got one mind track.
Okay, I don't mind. Yeah, we can speak.
She's going to post it online and make you look like an idiot.
I don't mind that.
Are you saying he looks like an idiot?
What they do all the time, week in, week out, is what they do. So you're just wasting your time. Yeah? They're going to talk about whenever a Muslim does something, they're going to talk about it.
Now we notice it is Muslim who did what, sir? Yeah. You said in some occasions in Islam it is all right to kill.
Yeah.
Okay?
Do you think? Yeah, by the modern law, even in some situations.
Let me finish my sentence.
If someone comes here.
I haven't finished my sentence.
But you didn't let me finish the first. Mr.
Muslim, I haven't even finished my sentence.
I am giving an example.
Okay?
By the modern law. But someone is coming to kill me. Okay?
So you need to defend yourself.
Yes, but by the law, to save my life, I can kill the person. If the terrorist person come here with the knife or the gun, if killing the people can be killed by the law, every law, modern law, in some situation, in this modern law, even some people can be killed. But in what situation? This lady was killed. I don't know what is the situation.
Okay,
what is the reason?
Okay,
I don't think so. Just only the
You are telling me that if someone comes to kill you, you need to defend yourself, and if it is necessary, you can kill that person.
By the law.
Now listen to me. And you said in some circumstances Islam allows you to kill. Okay, so in the story I read it to you, listen.
Yes.
In the story I read you to Muslim, Mr. Muslim.
Huh?
According to story,
yeah.
Muhammad heard what she said. So she said something about Muhammad. She did not come with the guns or with the sword to kill Muhammad. Muhammad says, who will get rid of her for me? Who will get rid of the Asma bin Marwan for me? And then person steps in and then goes and kills her. Is that defense? Is that Muhammad is defending himself?
But should be criticized, judged properly. Did he say to kill him? No. Can anyone help me to get rid of? Do you know the properly the incident?
Yes.
Yeah,
we do. I did read to you.
You don't know.
I did read it to you, sir. So now, what I am hearing from Mr. Muslim is he is trying to justify how Muhammad was killing his critics because they wrote poem against him. He's trying to justify. In the beginning, it was all about defense. If I come and punch this gentleman, he has right to defend himself. But now, if I show this picture to him, and his feelings are hurt, he needs to defend himself from this picture, who can't even punch you, you know? This picture can't even say much to you. What you do is, you come and then kill him. And he simply says, yeah, it's acceptable. You are trying to justify that.
In this time.
Are you aware that you are trying to justify killing of the France?
Listen, in this, I am condemning. Definitely.
Are you condemning Muhammad?
Condemning who?
Are you condemning Muhammad? Are you condemning Muhammad?
Muhammad.
John, listen. Are you condemning Muhammad? That's all I'm asking you.
Muhammad, the
Prophet one.
Forbidding the people killing innocent people.
Here's the problem. What is the definition of innocent? Can you tell me what is the definition of innocent for you?
But you are not listening to me.
What is the definition of innocent?
Innocent?
Yeah, means, what is innocent means?
Innocent means doesn't do anything to people, means doesn't threat of the people's life or something. Yes.
So, give me the definition of innocent again.
Innocent?
Am I innocent? Am I innocent if I steal a cake? No, I'm not innocent.
No, you are innocent.
If I steal a cake.
It is not enough crime to be killed. Yeah, it can be, it's crime, but you will go to, you will be judged.
They will just chop my hand off.
I don't know what is the procedure to be caught or the punished for stealing.
Okay.
But in some situation, I am going to say something. In this time, in the Prophet's time, there is no modern, the wild society. One poem, sometime causing the big war. Poem is very popular, very important at this time. Sometime one poem finished the war, very important. And if you in this reading poem, if this poem causing the 10 people's life all the time, and maybe. This is maybe the reason this lady can be stopped. Very important time. The people popular. What is popular now in this modern century? Science. In this time, one poem starts the war. Sometimes one and causing the how many. Plenty people's life.
What kind
one
of
poem?
One kind of
finish the war.
I hear.
White society. John, there is
Mr.
No,
Muslim, focus
there
now.
There is no.
Mr. Muslim, focus now.
In modern sense.
So here, what we are hearing is poem is so powerful, can cause you to start a war and finish the war. Okay, give me an example.
More powerful than gun sometimes.
Give me an example of poem.
In this society, at this time, very powerful, very society.
You are saying the same junk to me. Are you not aware what I'm asking you? What was my question to you?
Madam, you said give me
question. What was my question to you?
You give me some example, you said.
Example of what? Are you aware? There is something very serious is happening. followers of religion of Islam, who are also the sharing the same religion with you, are taking the life of individuals, because individuals are showing the pictures of Muhammad. Just a moment. John, John, can you look at the Sammy? Sammy is not on the lead. Sorry. They are taking the life of individuals because they show the picture at the time of Muhammad. Life of individuals are being taken away because Asma bin Marwan simply wrote a poem, and according to you, that poem is gonna cause start of the war or the finish of the war. So let me finish. Oh, you are condemning that was wrong.
Condemning the France.
I'm not asking you France right now.
Yeah.
Because person who did the France.
Yeah.
Looked at this example man called Muhammad.
Yeah.
They follow the examples of Muhammad, and then they take the life of that teacher. I am asking, are you condemning Muhammad? And then I gave you the example. Are you condemning Muhammad?
By writing poem, if the, she caused the war and caused.
She didn't cause the war. She was a woman who was breastfeeding her child.
You don't know.
I don't know. According to Islamic tradition, Islamic tradition tells me. Islamic tradition tells me her poem of woman. What is that poem is gonna do?
Poem causing the war at this time.
You're lying now. You're just lying. You're lying to defend your fake prophet.
You don't know the situation.
You're lying to defend your fake and ugly prophet.
If poem caused 10 people life, this is more than gun. You know that.
You are still saying the same junk, and you are not making any sense. So, are you condemning Muhammad or not? Yes or no? Yes or no?
More than
are you happy with the Muhammad's action? Yes or no?
If the poem
are you happy with the action of Muhammad? Yes or no?
You are listening me. You are ignoring.
Are you happy with the Muhammad's action? Yes or no?
What do you mean?
Are you happy with what Muhammad did, or you are not happy?
I don't know this incident is real. What is the...
If it is real for the sake of the argument, Okay, if it is not real, I will apologize. If it is real, would you condemn for Muhammad for the action? If it is real, say, if it is real. If it is not real, I will apologize. But if it is real, are you condemning?
Your knowledge is very poor.
My knowledge is very poor.
Yes, poor. You don't know. If the poem causing the 10 people, 100 people's life, I don't know, maybe by the law or the what.
Still the same caution, junk. Caution what is it with the followers of Islam? They cannot even say, I am ashamed what my prophet did. You should be shamed what he did. You should be shamed how he is causing damage to humanity. Yeah. You should be shamed. There is no any other way. You cannot get away around this. Oh, let's see the poem. Oh, let's hear what the poem is going to cause. A woman is writing a poem. Muhammad is getting offended, ordering her to be killed. And then that's not enough. He says the person who killed her had God and had prophet. Now, people, your brothers, Muslims, your brothers, who takes the Quran seriously and who takes their prophet seriously, goes and kills the individuals because they show the pictures of Muhammad. Why? Example.
IS is terrorist. Muslim cannot be terrorist.
Allah is a terrorist, Muhammad is a terrorist, angels are terrorists. You can insist what you want to insist, but that goes against this book. According to this book, Allah is a terrorist who caused terror in the hearts of individuals. Angels are terrorists who caused terror in the hearts of individuals. Muhammad is a terrorist who practiced that. And I don't know, some of the followers of Islam are taking life. Some of them are not. Those of you who take this book seriously, you will represent where you come from.
IS is terrorist. Muslim cannot be terrorist.
Yeah, they can. ISIS is following Muhammad. Muslims are following Muhammad.
They are terrorists.
So
what are they?
Muhammad
then?
Is not Muslim.
So what are they then?
Muhammad is not Muslim.
Cannot be both of them.
Why does it not be both of them?
Contradiction.
No,
Muslim. They rape British women. Terrorism, and they. So.
No, cannot be. Cannot be.
You can say they cannot be.
By the Quran,
maybe you know it is very ugly and dangerous. But according to teachings of Islam, that's how it is. Allah is a terrorist, Surah 8:12. Angels are terrorists, Surah 8:12. Muhammad was terrorist all of his life, simply says. And some of the followers of Islam simply killing the individuals because individuals are holding such a pictures of Muhammad. What does that make? Lovers of Muhammad. Whatever label you choose, but at the bottom line, it is very ugly. And this ideology is very dangerous. And Muslims are trying to justify that. Oh, depend what kind of poem was. Doesn't matter. What happened to the freedom of speech? Islam takes away your freedom. Islam takes away your dignity. Islam takes away your value. And takes away your life because you shove the picture of Muhammad. Wonderful ideology. Is getting ready to take over Britain. Wonderful ideology is getting ready to take over the world. Why? According to Islam, Islamic teachings, Islam is going to take every house one day. If you haven't freaked out, this is the moment you need to freak out and concern with the teachings of Islam. This is the moment. Before it is too late, people, you need to wake up. Today we can simply say, oh, it is in France. Last year it was in London. Last year it was in Manchester. And one day it's gonna be your loved ones, or one day it's gonna be you. But that time it's gonna be too late, because untouchable Islam, no one touched this untouchable Islam, no one touched this untouchable man. And they took over, they took over, they took over, and you say goodbye to your life. Unacceptable. If you want peace to one another, if you want to be okay by being mocked, ridiculed, Lord Jesus Christ, when he going to the cross, he was mocked. People slandered him. Yet he died for those who mocked him. He died for those who put the nails in his hand. He died for those who put nail in his feet. He didn't say, I'm gonna cut your throat off, I'm gonna chop your head off because you put those nails in my hand. He says, come to me, all those who are thirsty, I will give you, I am the living water. He says, come to me, pass your burdens to me, I will carry them for you. My heart is gentle and lowly. I'll forgive you. Versus 7th century man changes everything once for all. Goodbye to freedom of speech. Goodbye to life. And welcome to the world of Islam.